This is the marking support for Chapter 12, My Practice. Question 3 requires you to do a couple of constructions once you've drawn a large triangle. Here's my large triangle. You need to do a perpendicular bisector on each of the sides. I'm going to do it on one and then show you the picture of what it should look like. So we've got stab it in the corner, make sure it's over halfway, draw an arc, draw an arc. Okay, stab it in this corner, draw an arc, draw an arc. There's the two crossing points, and we can just join those up. Okay, that has perpendicularly bisected the first side. After drawing the other two constructions and making the first one a little bit longer, you can see that all three of them cross over at the same point, right here. Now that's on an edge on my picture, but depending on how you've drawn your triangles, it could be anywhere. To finish, you need to draw a circle which has got a centre at this point and its edge should touch each of these three. So I'm going to start with the centre, start with that lined up, and hope that as I draw the circle it goes through all the vertices, which it does. Question 4 requires you to draw a vertical wall between a giraffe and a person. The first thing I'm going to do is draw the floor in, and then my wall needs to be perpendicular to this, so I'm going to be doing a perpendicular bisector starting at that point there. So start with the compass, draw an arc one side, an arc the other. I'm now going to change my compass so it's a bit bigger. Up, down, up, all down, and then join them up. I'm going to stop at the floor, but I could keep going to the point, and there is my wall. For question 5, you need to draw the loci of points which are equidistant from P and Q. Equidistant means the same distance from P and Q. Now, since it says draw and not construct, I don't need to use compasses. I could do a perpendicular bisector of P and Q, and that would create the line down the middle. But as it's on squared paper, and as it says the word draw, I'm just going to go exactly halfway, but then it's going to be a vertical line, because that's 2 and that's 2, whereas here that's the same distance as well. Okay, so all of the line that I've drawn, that's about 2, all of the line that I've drawn is equidistant from P and Q. So following this idea, we're going to have that one creates a horizontal line, and then carefully using the squares, the line that goes like this is going to be between this one. So I'm going to draw it like that. If you need any more help with the marking of this section, please email your teacher.